And welcome to worship. The morning's centering words are based on 1 Peter chapter 1. Be not dismayed, for Christ is alive, bringing hope and joy to our lives this day. Hallelujah. Please stand as you are able. Hallelujah. Christ is risen. Do not worry or fear, for Christ is alive.
In his grace we find hope and joy.
Hallelujah! Christ is risen.
Let us worship the one who brings new life.
And our invocation in unison. Life-giving God, we gather today to celebrate the resurrection of your Son. We are grateful for the new life he brings. We are grateful for the hope and joy he shares. We are grateful for the leading way as he goes before us. Gracious God, today and every day, we offer you our thanks and praise. Strengthen our faith that it may sustain us during difficult days and enable us to share your love with others. Open our hearts to new life and new possibilities. In the name of Christ we pray. Amen. Our opening hymn, Christ has Risen, is found on the theme TFWS, and it is in number 2115. Number 2115. God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth,
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Please be seated. Our proclamation and response in unison. God of mercy and grace, you understand us completely. Yet there are times when we do not understand this life of faith. We do not understand how Jesus rose from the dead. We do not understand how his resurrected Christ comes to us today. Moments of doubt and disbelief sap our strength. Forgive us and restore us. Help us trust you and you will love us. And help us trust the ways of Christ.
Amen.
And our words of assurance, which is found in John chapter 20, verse 23. Jesus said to his disciples, if you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven.
Beloved children of God, you are forgiven. May this forgiveness bring peace to your souls, your minds, and your body. Amen.
And our hymn of response, Jesus, keep me near the cross. It is found on our United Methodist hymnal number 301. Number 301.
Thank you.
Amen. This is our sharing of joys and concern.
I was going to invite Renee to continue on with our joys and concerns. And so at this moment, we've come to our sharing our joys and concerns, and thank you to our liturgist Renee and our musician Harry for leading us this morning in worship. So any joys and concerns to be shared this morning? Yes, Nathan. And that's your cousin, what's your cousin's name?
Jeremy.
And so he?
He tried a motorcycle and
broke his hip.
Broke his hip, okay. Ooh, that wasn't fun. I ask that we keep Jeremy in your prayers, and we hope that Jeremy will heal from his broken hip, and I trust and believe that you will update us, or keep us updated with Jeremy's condition. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Amen. And while we're on, Nathan, I think it deserves a clap for you being back here with us. So that's a joy. Yes, let's give Nathan an applause. Yes, we missed you so much, and we know that you were being cared by your parents and your great grandma and your family members, and we're so happy and glad to have you back with us, and with no crutches. But I encourage everyone to continue holding Nathan in prayer as he continues his healing process. So, Lord, in your mercy and joy,
hear our prayers.
Amen. Yes, go ahead, Nathan. Oh, wow. Well, thanks God that he's still here with us on earth. So,
the doctor said he's still going to die, but it's a miracle how he's still alive. He should have been dead.
Oh, wonderful. Well, thank you for sharing that with us, Nathan. And you know what? That's what our message is about faith and knowing that everything is on God's timing. So thank you for sharing that with us. And we will hold your dad's friend in our prayer as well. So, Lord, in your mercy and joy,
hear
our prayers. Amen. Okay, I have Annie and then Melino.
Okay. I have a joy. On yesterday, the United Women in Faith held their Quad Disciple event. And it was held in the United Methodist Church in Monterey Park. And one of the recipients that were announced was one of our own. So at the announcement time, I'll announce that.
Amen. Yes, Lord, in your joy,
hear
our prayers. Amen. You know, I must have written that incorrectly in my calendar, because I had that listed for today. I didn't know it was yesterday. So, but thank you, Daniel. Yeah, that was my fault. I'm gonna have to check. Yeah, I don't know why I had a date for today. And it was on my calendar, so thank you, Annie. Yes, Melino.
It's a joy that today is my brother's birthday.
Amen to that. Yes, Lord, in your joy, hear our prayers. It is my Golo's birthday today. He turns 16 on the 16th. Yes, so. Yes. Yes, Melino.
It's a joy that tomorrow I'm having my first trip.
Field trip, yes. Lord, in your joy, hear our prayers. So tomorrow, Melino will be going on his very first field trip to the LA Zoo. And it's a shock and a surprise that mommy will not be with him. So, yeah, so, but that won't stop us from following the bus. No, I'm just kidding. So it'll be his first field trip since they returned to school since the pandemic. So slowly but surely, yeah. Did someone have a hand up here? Did anyone have any other joys or concerns that they wanted to share with us this morning?
The weather's beautiful.
Yes, yes. joy for the weather. In our area, it rained on Thursday and Friday, so I know it didn't rain out here, but it was a nice drive this morning. So, Lord, in your joy, hear our prayers. Amen. And I just want to welcome new friends that are here with us this morning. We're so glad to have you here with us, and I don't like to put people on the spot because I know some people don't like to be embarrassed, but we're grateful to have you here this morning. We have Harry's mom with us, and you're more than welcome to join us here to worship on Sunday. So thank you. Thank you for being here with us. Is there any other joys or concerns that would like to be shared with us this morning? And for those joys and concerns that are not spoken for us to hear, I encourage you to continue keeping them in your prayers, keep them in your hearts, and keep them lifted up to the Lord. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we're so grateful for the time that you have enabled and allowed us to gather in your presence. We ask you, Lord, the names that have been spoken aloud and in our hearts. We're so grateful for our little disciple, our little beloved that is back with us in worship, Nathan, and we thank you for the healing process that he continues to experience so that he can be back to his so-called normal self. Lord, we lift up to you his cousin Jeremy. We ask you to please grant your healing hands upon him and to help him to heal from his broken hip. We also ask you, Lord, to please give guidance and just praise and thanks for Nathan's dad's best friend, for whatever situation he is able to overcome to continue being surrounded by loved ones. We're so grateful, Lord, for your disciples of the United Women in Faith and our leaders that have continued to attend things such as workshops as for to help us, to equip us, not just for our own selves, but to be better disciples so that we can better serve your people. Lord, we lift up to you all the concerns, joys, situations that are in our hearts. Because we know, Lord, you hold the key, you hold the answer, you hold the healing hands that are able to grant the comfort, the peace, the joy, the love, the grace, and the blessings to all our prayers. And we lift up all these to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, as you have taught us how to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And also, Lord, please don't forget your little disciples that we celebrate the days of years that have been spent on this earth. Your little disciple, Michael, who has reached his 16th birthday, and your young disciples that will be traveling tomorrow on a field trip. We ask you, Lord, for your guidance, for your protection, and for your grace and love. In Jesus' name, amen.
Our scripture reading is found on 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 to 9. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who are being protected by the power of God through the faith for salvation ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you rejoice, Even if now for a little while you have suffered, you have had to suffer various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, being more precious than gold, that though perishable is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Although you may not have seen him, you love him. And even though you did not see him now, you believe in him and rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy. For you are receiving the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The stories of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
For those in need of this world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please be seated. I want to apologize to our little disciples. I thought I brought along my children's moment story, but I did not. And so I hope that you will be able to just get a glimpse of the message or the scripture today from my message. And so I promise to be more prepared and ready next Sunday for our children's moment, because you are a vital and important part of our worship service. Okay, but I know you'll enjoy fellowship. Yeah. And so at this time, I'd like to invite Linda for the announcements.
I believe we are still seeking a custodian. So if you know anybody who's interested, please let the office know. I had announced last week that our co-ministry has ended for this year, in part. We're not giving away coats anymore until October. We'll pick up next October until April. But that doesn't mean we've stopped collecting coats. And I have got to say, I have been so thrilled with the response of the town making donations. And the last donation was made this past Wednesday. But as you're getting your winter clothes away, if you find things that I don't need it anymore. I don't like it anymore. I want something new, and it's good. Please bring it to church for our, that we'll build up for next year. We would like to have a rummage sale June 3rd. But before we can have a rummage sale, I have to know we have something to sell. I can't advertise and then have people come and not have anything here. So on the paper that I gave you, it says the rummage sale, we're looking for items that you could donate to the church to sell. Or you could set up your own table and put your items on it and sell. We need help setting up and pricing what is brought in. We have no place at church to store things. This is a problem. So if you have a corner of the garage or a shed that you're not using right now, that you could let us bring things and put it in it until the 3rd of June, we'd appreciate it. We need people that work with the sale, cleaning up after, and helping advertise. So those are any and all ways that you could help there. I'd like to start advertising by April 26th. So if you have things, let me know before then. On April 29th, along with donating coats, people have been donating children's clothes and sweaters and blouses and shirts and pants, and we have no place to store those either. And since they were donated to us with the coats to be given away, on April 29th, we want to set up in the parking lot, not to sell, but all of the clothes that were donated other than coats, and let the community come and take them. So again, I'm going to need help setting up and tearing down for that. Our pantry is still open on Wednesdays from 9 to 12, so if you know of anyone that needs supplemental food, bring them this way. On Tuesday, April 25th, we'll have our next Bible study on Zoom at 7 p.m., so look for information when Pastor sends that out with the link. Last week, we had our Easter baskets and gave out Easter eggs. If you have no use for those eggs, could you bring them back to church and we'll have them for next year? If you can use them, then keep them.
Thank you. I have an announcement, and I will announce, and Pastor is my legs, and so she's standing up, and we'll make the presentation. On last Saturday, we had an event, United Women of Faith, and the title of the event was Quiet Disciple, a Hidden Gem. Quiet Disciple, a Hidden Gem. And our Quiet Disciple and Hidden Gem is Missy Toloso. And you see there is a correction for your certificate, and I'll have that corrected. The pastor's going to read so that everyone can hear what it was. I mean, Missy had two nominations. So when you see your letter, you understand that some of it is repetitive. And so that, for me, that was great, that people had the same, you know, thought. So I didn't see that until the event on Saturday. Then it was also revealed to me.
Yes, so thank you, Annie. So I'm going to read, right? Am I reading this?
You're reading that.
Oh, this part, okay. Because this is all wonderful, too.
I know.
Yes. Yes, I would like to read it, if that's okay. And so for those of you who are not aware of our United Women in Faith, it was formerly known as the United Methodist Women. And this is not local, this is global. So they're recognized all over the world. And this particular certificate, it's an actual certificate, is recognized for our East District. And so it's East District United Women in Faith, Quiet Disciple, a Hidden Gem, Certificate of Appreciation to Mitzi Tolosa. And I'm just going to read what the description here is that she has been recognized for as a quiet disciple recipient. Mitzi has a very quiet and friendly personality. She offers and helps with special projects. She has coordinated music with her husband when we had no musicians by providing music through voice and guitar to enhance our services. Her creative talents shine as she planned the decoration of our sanctuary for Palm Sunday. Her computer skills help us get advertising of special events at the church. She provides fresh flowers to beautify the altar each Sunday and delicious food for our fellowship after church. She also has accepted the position of the financial secretary. Mitzi makes, quote unquote, a cross in my pocket to be handed out to people visiting church so they have a reminder of their experience with us. Her beautiful smile and gentle ways put people at ease. God has provided us with this special person and we thank her for all she has done. Mitzi uses her talents in many ways. She provides music through voice and guitar to enhance our services. Her creative talents shine as she plans and decorates our sanctuary for occasions that have to do with worship. And then it goes on, her beautiful smile and gentle ways put people at ease. So let's give her another round of applause. And it has a little gem on it, so.
Praise be to God, this is all for our Lord.
Thank you. And again, I apologize for having the incorrect date of our quiet disciple. And I knew something was up when it was on a Sunday, and I thought, I have this wrong date. So yes, we're very proud of you. Thank you, Mitzi, and your many gifts that you share with us. So praise be to God. Just to add to our announcements, for those of you who plan to attend our annual conference in person, registration is open. Even if you don't plan to attend in person, registration is still open because they will be live streaming as it was last year. So for those who are going to be attending in person, which I believe is just Annie and myself, right, Annie? We're going to get all our bookings and everything in order. But for those of you who are, that will not be attending in person, that will be voting, please register. I believe registration
is still open.
It's open, but there's a certain date that if you pass, you have to pay. So right now, registration is free. But if you pass the deadline, I think you pay $50. So get in while there's no fee for those of you who have voice to vote. And even if you don't have votes but you have voice, I encourage you to register for our annual conference. And that way you'll be able to keep up to date with what's going on in the conference, the district, and what affects us locally. And our annual conference dates are from June the 14th to the 17th. Yeah, so beginning the 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th. So it's a 4-day event, and it'll be held at the Sheraton Gateway in Los Angeles. Okay, so for those of you.
Pastor, I don't have the date for the district.
Oh, yes.
District.
Yes, our district conference is first, and I believe that's May. I'll have to check, but I'll send the email. I think I sent it out, but I'll send the email. I'll send the email again, because if you register for annual conference, it registers you for district first. So you register for district and annual conference at the same time. And I encourage you all to attend. Please attend. It is on Zoom. It will be on a Saturday. I don't know which Saturday in May. I'll have to confirm that through email. But I encourage you to attend because that's where your voices are heard through our district. And then it's shared to our conference in our Cal Pacific annual conference. And that way, whatever concerns you have and leaders and things of that nature that impacts our local church, that will be shared at our district conference, which will be coming up.
You vote.
We'll be voting at our district level that will be carried out to our annual conference level. So I encourage you all for those, and it's, I believe it'll just be an hour. I don't think it ever runs over an hour, right?
I think it's
2 hours?
1 to 3.
Oh, 1 to 3 hours. But I'll send the link and the confirmation of all that through email. And all that is found in our CalPacUMC.org webpage if you don't want to wait, if you just want to go and look at it now. The tab is AC23, Annual Conference 2023. And before you know it, we'll be there. We'll be at a district conference, and then we'll be at our annual conference. And so I encourage you. Oh, no, go ahead. I'm just encouraging people to attend if you can.
And you don't have to do the annual conference. You can do the district conference. It's Zoom. So you can do that and be a part of that, because that kind of lets you know how we function locally and our pastors and who's being voted for whom. And you do not have to, because it says, check up whether you're going to your district or not. And you can just check that off and you'll still get all the information about everything else. And you can download and use your ink and your paper to get all of the other things that are there. But I really encourage you to become a part of the district conference. And you get a chance to meet the new district superintendent.
Yes, yeah, and our new incoming district superintendent. I'm not sure if she'll join us for the district conference. Oh, no, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know if she'll be able to join us or not. Our new district superintendent coming in July 1st is Reverend Moon Young Lee. I'm not sure, but we'll find out.
I didn't know she would have a picture of it.
Oh, yeah, or she might have a picture. Yeah, that's true, since it's on Zoom. But if she is able to join us, on Zoom, that would be great. But if not, they'll introduce her by picture. And she's a really nice person as well. And for those of you who know, our current district superintendent, Reverend Sayat Uitahi, will be moving to the West District. So West District, East District, and then Hawaii District are the three districts that are transitioning district superintendents. A lot of changes. And currently, our district superintendent himself is in a cabinet, and with the cabinet meeting, and the cabinet are all the district superintendents of our conference, all five with the bishop. And they are currently having their conference, their own meeting in Hawaii, which I hope to hear from him by next week to announce who our lay person assigned here for 29 will be beginning of July 1st, and as soon as the SPRC confirms that, and myself will make that announcement, because I know some people were asking if I knew where I was appointed to yet, and I have not been given a name of where my next appointment will be. So as soon as the SPRC and myself receive that, we'll announce that as well. So a lot of changes within our conference itself. So I believe that's pretty much the announcements I wanted to add. Any more announcements from our leaders? Annie, Nancy, Renee? No? Okay. And so I did forget on our joys and concerns. Melino and Michael bought a cake for the church to share and celebrate Michael's birthday today. So part of fellowship will be Michael's birthday cake to add for fellowship. And so if we can sing happy birthday for Michael, and would like to ask him to come forward so he can stand here and sing. I know we do birthdays on the last of the month, but since today is his actual birthday, we would like the church to sing for him since his day is shared with the Lord's day. Isn't that a blessed way to spend your sweet 16, right?
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Mary.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
That's how we do it.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Harry, for that. So yeah, so I hope you all enjoy the cake that Michael and Melino picked for fellowship to share today on behalf of Michael's birthday. If that is all the announcements for us today, I invite you to stand as you are able, either in body or in spirit, for our second hymn. Our second hymn is found in our Blue United Methodist Hymnal Book, page 307. 307, Christ is Risen. To the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 19 through 31. And this is how it's written. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hand, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing, you may have life in his name. These are the inspiring words of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, as we prepare our minds, our souls and our hearts to receive your word. I ask that you please allow us to take the message that you will speak to us here today, so that we can share it with all those that we come across, so that they will know your grace, your love, your peace, and your joy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And so today's message is titled, Faith in Christ. Faith in Christ. And so the gospel reading that we just heard from John chapter 20, verses 19 through 31, is a powerful reminder of the significance of faith in our lives as Christians. This passage recounts the story of Jesus appearing to his disciples after his resurrection and Thomas's initial skepticism. This story also teaches us about the importance of faith and belief in Christ, even in times of doubt and uncertainty. As we heard in the gospel, the passage began with the disciples locked in a room, afraid of the Jews. Jesus appeared to them and said, "Peace be with you." He even showed them his hands and his side, revealing the wounds from his crucifixion. The disciples were overjoyed to see the Lord, and Jesus repeated his words, "Peace be with you." And then after that, he breathed on them and instructed them to receive the Holy Spirit. And this encounter, this was a turning point for the disciples who had previously been filled with fear and doubt. They were transformed by the presence of the risen Christ and the gifts of the Holy Spirit. They had witnessed the power of the resurrection, and then now they were filled with a renewed sense of hope and purpose. Remember, it wasn't too long ago during Holy Week and during Holy Saturday that we sat with the disciples and we grieved with them. We grieved with them as they just lost their teacher, their friend. And they couldn't believe it. They didn't know what to do. And today, here, we're listening and reading the witness of the power of the resurrection and being renewed in that sense, that hope, and that purpose. And so there was a man named Robert. Robert had been a devout Christian his whole life, but he struggled with doubt. He read the Bible, he attended worship service every Sunday, and he prayed regularly, but he still couldn't shake the feeling that God wasn't real. I mean, how many of us can relate to that? And you don't have to raise your hands. Maybe none of us. Maybe none of us here can relate to that. But there are faithful followers of Christ, Christians, that are just like Robert. And so one day, Robert was walking through the park when he saw a group of children playing. And one of the kids had fallen and scraped their knee. And so the other children gathered around, but none of them knew what to do because they were little children. And so Robert approached them and asked if he could help. He knelt down beside the injured child and started to clean the wound. And as he did, he began to talk to the child and ask the child questions about their life. And so the child told Robert about their family and their struggles. And Robert listened intently. And so after a while, minutes passed by, the child smiled and said, "Thank you for making me feel better." And so Robert realized at that moment that he had been the hands and feet of Christ. He had shown compassion and love to a child in need. And he really felt God's presence more strongly than ever before. And so some of us may have not experienced that in that particular situation, but we are in life situations that we're able to experience God's love and God's compassion. In John 20:27, Jesus tells Thomas,
put your finger here. See my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Stop doubting and believe. And just like Thomas, Robert had to see and experience the power of faith before he could truly believe. But Jesus goes on to say in verse 29, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed. And this is a reminder to us all that faith doesn't always come from seeing miracles or signs. Sometimes it comes from the everyday acts of kindness and love that we show to one another. Thomas, one of the disciples, was not present when Jesus appeared to the others. And when he heard of it, he expresses doubt, saying that he will not believe unless he sees Jesus for himself and touches his wounds. But then yet here we heard in the scriptures, a week later, Jesus appears again, and Thomas is there. Thomas is able to see. And Thomas declares his faith, my Lord, oh my God. I mean, this story reminds us of the power of faith, even in the face of doubt and uncertainty. The disciples were afraid and insecure of what the future held, but when they saw Jesus, they were filled with hope and joy. But yes, Thomas had doubts. But when he saw Jesus for himself, he was able to declare his faith and become a believer. In our own lives, we may also experience doubt and uncertainty. We may be afraid of what the future holds or unsure of our own abilities. But we can take comfort. We can take comfort in the fact that we are not alone. Jesus is always with us, and Jesus gives us the strength and courage that we need to face whatever challenges come our way. I know that in our journey of faith and our walks of life, we're told to believe what we don't see. We're told not to believe everything that we see. But here we hear this witness, this confirmation. The disciples that were present and a disciple that wasn't present. Believing something that you don't see. When people say, oh, well, how can you believe in God if you don't see God? How can you believe in a God that doesn't show up? How can you believe in a God that doesn't show his presence? But God doesn't have to show up to us to know, because God is in each and every one of us. God is in the places and the things that are in our lives that show godly things, that show Christ-like things. We ourselves are not God, but God directs and leads us. And to have faith and to trust and to obey. And I know that it's hard. It is hard. And we struggle. But the more that we continue to stay faithful, the more that we continue to stay on that path, that we follow Christ, it gets less and less challenging. I'm not saying it's going to be easy, smooth riding, but the rewards of it, the blessings that we receive upon it, it's unexplainable. And I know each and every one of you has experienced that type of blessing, has experienced God's love, God's grace. Even though it doesn't come when we ask, even though it doesn't come when we demand it, but it will come. And you will experience God's grace, God's love, God's peace. But let me tell you one more story. It's a very short one. And so there was a woman named Mary. And Mary was walking home from work when she saw a homeless man sitting on the sidewalk. But she had seen him there before. And she had never stopped to talk to him. But something compelled her to stop this time. Something was nudging at her to stop and acknowledge this individual. So she sat down beside the man and asked him about his life. He told her about his struggles with his addiction and how he had lost everything. And so Mary continued to listen, and then she offered him to buy him a meal, dinner.
So they walked to a nearby deli and they sat and ate. So Mary then talked to the man and shared with him her struggles and how her faith helped her through the struggles. And this man listened intently. And by the end of the meal, he had tears in his eyes. And he said to Mary, "Thank you for seeing me as a person and not as a problem. I've never felt so loved and cared for." And so Mary realized at that moment that she just showed this stranger, this individual, the love of Christ, the type of love that Jesus would offer anyone on the streets, anyone that he would pass by. And so for Mary, it took her a while to realize the nudge that was compelling her to talk to this individual. And I'm not inviting you or instructing you to go and do the same thing, even though I know that you all participate in helping with the less fortunate. But these are stories of faith, because until we're able to see it, we don't believe. And so these type of faith stories are reminders. Sometimes we don't need to see to believe because we know it. And then some of us need to see everything to confirm what we already know or believe. But I encourage you and confirm to you the assurance of faith is that we worship a living God. God, a living God, that continues to bless us, to continue to love us, to continue that cares for us and protects us, is a God that we don't need to see. Because the things that we have experienced and endured in life cannot be done alone by ourselves. Christ walks with us and is with each and every one of us, even in our doubts and in our uncertainties. And we may not always see Jesus with our own eyes, but we can experience his love and his grace and the kindness and compassion that we show to one another. When we have doubts, we can turn to the scripture for guidance and inspiration. We can read the stories of the disciples and their encounters with Jesus. And then we can remember that they too had doubts and fears, but through their faith, they were able to overcome their doubts and become stronger and faithful followers of Christ. As we go about our lives, let us remember the words of Jesus. Peace be with you. Let us have faith in his presence and trust in his love. And let us never forget that even in the darkest moments, we are never alone, for Jesus is guiding us. Jesus is strengthening us. And yes, Jesus walks along our side. In the midst of our doubts and uncertainties, we can surely turn to God in prayer and ask for guidance and strength. And we can also seek out the support of our church family, our faith community, which can help us to understand and deepen our faith. We can always turn to Scripture, which offers us a roadmap for navigating the challenges of life and the questions that we may face. Faith in Christ. Whether if you have to see it to believe it, or know that you don't have to see it at all. But as Christ followers, as Christians, we are called to embrace a faith that is both rational and mystical. We are called to use our intellect and our understanding of the scriptures and the teachings of the church, but we are also called to open our hearts to the mystery of God's love and grace. We are called to trust in the promises of Christ, even when they seem impossible or beyond our comprehension. In conclusion, the story of Thomas teaches us about the importance of faith and the belief in Christ, even in times of doubt. Even in times when you're standing there and you're just like, God, what is going on? It reminds us that our faith is not based on physical evidence, but on the trust that we place in God's promises. As we continue our journey in faith, May we strive to deepen our understanding of God's love and grace. And may we trust in the power of the resurrection to transform our lives. Let us go forth and be the hands and feet of Christ in the world that you have been and continue to do. May the peace of Christ be with you always. Amen. I invite you to stand if you are able, either in body or in spirit, for our closing hymn found in the Faith We Sing, the Finn Book, page 2196. 2196, We Walk by Faith. Thank you.